Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. It is rightly said that knowledge doesn't come, but you have to go to it. Assalamu alaikum everyone. I welcome you all in today's online session by Army Public College, Sialkot, Kent. My name is Nagin Arshad, and the subject I am going to teach you is chemistry. As about my introduction, I did my master's in organic chemistry from Punjab University, Lahore in 2016. I joined Army Public School and College, Sialkot in 2017, and currently I am working as head of department of chemistry in Army Public College, Sialkot, Kent. That was all about my introduction. Dear students, the objectives for today's online session are, by this effort, I would try to invoke in you the importance of education. Then we will have a proper introduction of the subject, that is chemistry. And at the end, we will discuss the paper pattern and syllabus outlines. Coming towards chemistry, word chemistry is not new for you all. Dear students, you are already very well aware of this word. But the facts you are going to learn about this subject will surely amaze you. I mean, look around you, the food you eat, the clothes you wear, the paints and varnishes been used around you, pharmaceutical products, drugs, vaccines, everything is an outcome of chemistry. Isn't that amazing? And most importantly, according to the current scenario of the world, where scientists are striving to come up with the solution of the problem we are facing today, that is COVID-19, scientists are trying hard to come up with a vaccine. And for that, we are looking towards the wonders of chemistry. Now I'm going to discuss paper pattern and marks division for the paper of chemistry by Federal Board of Education. Dear students, total time allocated for this paper is 3 hours. The paper comprises of 4 sections. Section A is of MCQs. Kindly have a look. That 17 MCQs will be asked, each carrying 1 marks. So total marks allocated for section A are 17. Similarly, there is another section over here, section B. This is of short questions. The most important thing to note here is you will be given 10 short questions. You will have choice of 3 short questions, that is, you will have to solve 7 out of 10 short questions, each carrying 3 marks, so total marks allocated for this section will be 21. Same is the case with section C, again it is of short questions. You will have to solve 7 out of 10 short questions, each short question carries 3 marks, therefore total marks allocated for this section are 21. The last section of the paper comprises of long questions. You will have to solve 2 long questions out of 3. Each long question carries 13 marks, so total marks for this section are 26. In this way, total marks for the paper of chemistry will be 85. Dear students, I am going to show you a sample paper. By having a look on it, you will have a clear picture of the marks division, time allocation and all. Kindly have a look. This slide is showing you section A. Here is an outlook of the section B and section C. And at the end of the paper, section D is given. Kindly look at these slides vigilantly and try to understand the time allocation marks division. Now, I'm sharing over here the front page of your textbook. In case you want to buy a textbook, this is the recommended textbook by Federal Board of Education. I'm sharing over here the title page. So whenever you're going to buy this book, kindly have a look that it must be recommended by Federal Board of Education, and the book must be the same one as I'm showing you in this slide. Now here is the most important section. In this slide, the contents of your textbook have been shown, and these contents are actually the syllabus outlines as well. In first year, you deal with total 12 chapters. The names of these chapters are given over here. The first chapter is named as stoichiometry. Second chapter is named as atomic structure. Third, theories of covalent bonding. Now next three chapters are of states of matter. The chapter number four is state of matter, that is gases. The next one is of solids. Chapter number six is of solids. So chapter number four, five and six are all about gases, liquids and solids. Now coming towards chapter number seven, it is named as chemical equilibrium. Chapter number 8 is named as acids, bases and salts. Chapter 9, chemical kinetics. Chapter 10, solutions and collides. Chapter 11, thermochemistry. And last chapter of your book will be electrochemistry. The page numbers for these particular chapters from the textbook recommended by Federal Board of Education are also mentioned here. Kindly have a look. In the upcoming lectures, we will discuss all these chapters one by one. We will start discussing these contents from chapter number one, that is stoichiometry. So basically what I'm trying to convey is, in upcoming classes, we are going to start this recommended syllabus from chapter number one, named as stoichiometry. And when we will start discussing the chapter, I will share with you the outlines of the chapter in detail. Lastly, I would like to share with you the thought of the day. Nelson Mandela said, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world." Indeed, in today's scenario of the world, it is very evident that education is an answer to the questions we are facing these days. It is the solution of the problems. Thank you so much. Stay blessed. Stay safe.